So here, I'd like to mention few comparisons between the methods we have discussed earlier, that is impulse invariance method and bilinear transformation method. What type of effects they can able to give in filter design? Like suppose we know that in impulse invariance method, the poles are basically test as in the form that if my pole is 1 by s minus p I, this will have to represent in the form 1 minus e to the power p I t, where t is the sampling time period and the operator z inverse. So this is the way the poles can be represented. And here, the poles in bilinear transformation, the poles can be represented in the way that 2 by t z minus 1 by z plus 1. In this form, you can able to express the poles. Now here, what is the problem in impulse invariance method? That is the problem of aliasing. That means, especially when we are going over another thing, the value of omega. If we want to represent the value of omega, the omega is actually omega t, whereas here the value of omega is we are getting that the value of omega is a bit different, and it involves the trigonometrical function, that is the tan, and it is becoming 2 tan inverse omega t by 2. Here the value of omega is becoming 2 tan inverse omega t by 2. So we can write it as 2 tan inverse omega t by 2. So now here what we know that due to this type of mapping of omega between analog and digital frequencies mapping, there comes the effect of aliasing. Aliasing means it is actually many different omega values in the analog frequency is actually mapped into a limited region of minus pi to plus pi in digital frequency. So that is creating aliasing. The primary strip is properly mapping, but the secondary strips are mapping on the same area, same surface. So mapping is many to one. But in this case, as we have expressed the value of omega in this form, we can able to map each analog frequencies in unique digital frequency. That is the advantage of this bilinear transformation. Okay, so that's right. Here aliasing is present, but here aliasing is not present, and the mapping is one to one. That means one digital frequency is giving me the one and one analog frequency is giving me unique one digital frequency. But here it is not happening. That's why aliasing effect is present. Whereas in bilinear transformation, due to the value of relation between this analog omega and digital omega, this is not happening. That is, aliasing is not present. And as this here, only the primary strip is able to get you the unique value. So you can able to design this method for a low pass filter design. Okay, but if you go for the higher values of frequency, definitely it will not give you the proper value, because it is actually mapping them in the same area. Okay, so this method is good for LPF design. You cannot able to do the band pass filter or high pass filter with impulse invariance method. But as it is giving you unique transformation, you can able to design all different types of filter design using bilinear transformation. But though there is few disadvantage of this method too, but you can able to design it. Okay, but this impulse invariance method is restricted only for the locus venti. Another important part is frequency warping effect, which is not present in this impulse invariance method but present in bilinear transformation method. Now, what is frequency warping effect? Frequency warping effect is actually happens for the higher frequencies of this filter. And what happens, suppose if I draw the mapping of analog and digital frequency using bilinear transformation method, I can get these type of mapping. As it is a tangent function, so there will be a linear curve for the lower frequencies, but for the higher value of frequencies, this is omega and this omega. So for the higher values of frequencies, the values are going saturated. Okay. So when you are using the lower frequencies, it is actually mapping properly the values of lower frequencies. The values of lower frequencies are mapping properly. But when you are going for the higher values of frequencies, these values are being suppressed. They are not the value of omega is the wide spreading of omega is not actually reflected due to this saturation of the tangential curve. And this distortion is introduced for the higher frequencies in the frequency scale of digital filter to that of analog filter. This is known as warping effect. Okay, so this is known as the warping effect, and this happens in the bilinear transformation. So these are few comparison important points to remember about impulse invariance and bilinear transformation method. So, hope you understand it well. Thank you.